Here's the question. What volume of hydrogen sulfide formula H2S? It's not necessary that you should understand the chemistry here. What volume of hydrogen sulfide, H2S, reacts with 960 grams of oxygen? And you've been given this information along the top line. So pause and have a go, please. What volume of hydrogen sulfide gas, so I have to express this as cubic decimeters or cubic centimeters, reacts with 960 grams of oxygen? We begin by making an equivalence between what we're given and asked using the numbers in the balanced equation. We have been given information about the oxygen and asked information about the hydrogen sulfide, H2S. We do this using these numbers, 3 moles of oxygen, 2 moles of hydrogen sulfide. Because we've got information about this, I'd like to put it on the left. Cosmetically, it's just easier to work with. So I'm writing 3 moles of O2 is equivalent to, or reacts with, 2 moles of H2S. If 3 reacts to give 2, or reacts with 2, divide both sides by 3, so 1 mole of oxygen is equivalent to 2/3 of a mole of H2S. I've divided both sides of the equation by the same number, divided them both by 3. I now need to work out what 960 grams is in terms of moles of oxygen. Again, remember that moles are at the center of chemistry calculations. So I've got 960 grams of oxygen. So I'm going to convert that mass into moles. And once I have moles, I can get these other units just in one step. The relative atomic mass of oxygen is 16. The formula is O2. So 1 mole of O2 equals 32 grams, twice the relative atomic mass, because the formula shows a 2, O2. I could look to see if 960 and 32 are related. Is 32 a factor of 960? So 960 into the calculator divided by 32, and it goes into it 30 times. So 960 grams is 30 times the molar mass. You should recall that in order to get moles, we divide the mass by the relative molecular mass, which in this case is 960 divided by 32, and that gives us 30 mole of O2. Now, if 1 mole gives 2/3 of a mole, then 30 mole of oxygen, I've multiplied this side by 30, and I do the same to this side, I multiply by 30. So it's going to be 2/3 times 30 mole of H2S. The 3 goes into the 30 10 times, so that comes out to be 20 mole of hydrogen sulfide, H2S. We see at the top here that 1 mole of H2S, or indeed any gas, occupies 24 cubic decimeters at RTP. It didn't state the conditions. I'm going to assume it's room temperature and pressure. So this is equal to 20 times 24 cubic decimeters. So 224 is 48 times 10 is 480, so that comes out as 480 dm cubed of H2S. And we should underline our answer to set it out clearly for the marker to see.